In this video, you'll see how to deploy and use Cost Optimization and Savings Toolkit, or COAST dashboards for Amazon Managed Grafana. Using COAST dashboards, you can integrate performance, cost, and usage metrics for AWS resources to help promote financial accountability and achieve operational excellence. We'll begin by walking through the process of deploying COAST. COAST is deployed to Amazon Managed Grafana using AWS CloudFormation templates, which are available from this repository on GitHub. The location for this page is provided in the links to this video. For our purposes, the repository has already been cloned. The GitHub page also includes detailed instructions and helpful resources. Let's return to the AWS Management Console. Next, we'll navigate to AWS CloudFormation and deploy the first of three templates. We'll upload the provision data exports.yaml file we cloned. The first stack will enable users to provision data exports in order to create the cost and usage report, or CUR. It will also provide the resources necessary to integrate CUR data with Amazon Athena for use in Amazon Managed Grafana. Three data export types are supported: CUR Legacy, CUR 2.0, and Focus, currently in preview. We can deploy the template in a single account or in a management account. Let's quickly finish creating the stack. The template has deployed. Let's view the resources that were created. Notice that the resources all share the same suffix, which is the stack ID. We can see that CUR Legacy deployed. In addition, the template deployed a Glue database, Glue table, and Glue crawler to allow Athena to query the data, an S3 bucket for Athena query results, and the identity provider, or IDP, we provided. Next, let's go to the Billing and Cost Management Console to validate the CUR Legacy data export. The deployment appears and is still in progress. Next, we'll return to CloudFormation to create a second stack. This stack will build a new Amazon Managed Grafana workspace along with the necessary permissions. We will use this template, also from GitHub. Let's view the outputs. We have a physical ID for the workspace, an IAM role, and an SNS notification topic. Let's go to Amazon Managed Grafana to verify that we can see the workspace. The top workspace shares the same physical ID as the one we just created. Additionally, the values of the workspace name and workspace ID in our stack outputs match what's in the Grafana console. Next, we need to configure authentication and assign users to the workspace. This can be done through AWS IAM Identity Center or through an identity provider. The CloudFormation template creates the Grafana workspace with AWS IAM Identity Center enabled, so we can assign users from here. We'll make this user an admin. Now we can sign into our workspace. Let's look at the data source connections. Because this is a new data source, we don't have any connections yet. Let's go back to CloudFormation to provision a new stack to add a data source. We'll call this the Kerr legacy stack. In the parameters section, we'll need to provide information from our first two CloudFormation stacks. We can copy the values we need from the stack outputs. We won't do any optional stack configuration. Let's submit the stack. We'll also need a CloudWatch data source, which we will provision now. Again, we'll need to provide parameters from our other stacks. In this case, we'll select CloudWatch as the data export type. While the CloudWatch data source stack is provisioning, let's check on the Kerr legacy stack we created previously. This stack includes several Lambda functions. Now that the CloudWatch data source is finished creating, let's return to Grafana. Our two data sources are here. We're now ready to import our dashboards. The GitHub repository we cloned included several dashboards along with a README file for each. Let's import the Coast Executive dashboard. In this case, we need to select an Athena data source. It can take up to 24 hours for a new cost and usage report to populate. Once data is flowing in, the dashboard will look similar to this. We can filter the dashboard to see all or selected linked accounts, regions, services, granularity level, and charge types. There's a detailed explanation of how to use this dashboard. There's also a column validator that makes sure our Kerr dataset has the columns necessary to create this dashboard. The executive dashboard provides high-level visibility into an organization's overall cloud spending and cost trends. The invoice view displays unblended invoice amounts and will match the amounts in your AWS bills page. For instance, we can see month-over-month differences and spending in our top accounts. The summary view displays all unblended costs incurred in the selected time range. It includes month-by-month views of total costs, service spend per month, and region spend per month. By default, the time period shown is 1 year. We can change the time range, for instance, to show the last 30 days. Let's reset the time range to the past year. In this example, our data shows that we had a large transaction from one of our accounts. We can use the filters to narrow down the accounts displayed to find out which one. We can see that the costs per month normalize when we take out the account that had the large transaction on it. We can also look only at the one account with the large transaction. We can also see which service generated that spend. Clearly, it's Amazon EC2. In June, this account spent $855 on EC2. In July, it spent almost $4,000. Next, let's take a brief look at the auto-scaling dashboard. This dashboard requires both an Athena data source, which is the cost and usage report, and a CloudWatch data source. The Coast Autoscaling dashboard provides a comprehensive overview of cost and infrastructure performance metrics related to EC2 autoscaling groups, load balancers, NAT gateways, and networking across all associated resources. To use this dashboard, provide the region of the workload, the name of the autoscaling group you wish to monitor, and the workload cost allocation tag. The values for the NAT gateway and load balancer parameters will populate based on your selection for tags. Let's zoom in on one of the panels. We can click on the graph to view that day's compute costs. We can go to the resource index to see the resources that have been provisioned in the last 30 days. In this case, on July 7th, the instances went from extra large to large. We can go back to our graph and zoom in to where this change happened. We can add an annotation here to remind us of the change. To see the cost impact of the scaling activity we identified, we can look at the CPU over compute costs graph. The compute costs come from CUR, and the total instances come from CloudWatch. When the instance type changed from extra large to large, cost went down. But the next spike in traffic is nearly double that of the previous surge. This lets us compare the compute cost to performance impact of the change. We can also look at cost trends as we make changes to the autoscaling infrastructure. We can also look at networking, EBS volume, and other costs. You've just seen how to deploy and use Coast dashboards for Amazon Managed Grafana. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.